Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about the very interesting project, that is the diabetes prediction. So here we are applying the different classification algorithms to predict the whether the person has diabetes or not by using the Python program. So the problem statement here, so the objective of this diabetes data set is to predict whether the person has the diabetes or not. So the data set consists of the several medical predictors, means several input independent variables and one target variable. The name of the target variable is the outcome. So the predicted variables, the predictor means input variables. Predictor means this is the input variables. So here pregnancies, glucose, blood pressure, skin thickness, insulin, BMI, diabetes, pedigree function, age. So up to these functions, these features are the input features. The output feature is the only target variable. Target variable. So now we will go to the practical section. So this is the description of this project. So the objective of the data set is to predict whether the patient has the diabetes or not. So here the number of the input features are the pregnancies 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 7, 8. And this is the target variable. So this is the data set link. I will give in the description section this link section and this data set link. So here the names of the columns and with their meanings. So what is the here total 9 columns up to from 1 to 8. This is the input variables. So input features, the pregnancy. So this is the name of the feature. So which means this is the number of times the person is pregnant. So glucose. So this is the plasma glucose concentrations of the, this is the description of the data set, means this is the description of the input variables, and this is the output is the target variable. The target variable is the 0 or 1. So which means out of 768 rows, 268 rows belongs to the class 1 category. 500 rows, 500 observations out of 768 belong to the class 0 category, which means this is the binary classification. So binary classification, the target variable has only zeros and ones. So this is the description of the data set. So the steps are, the first step is to import the libraries. What are the basic libraries? NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, Seaborn, and Scikit-learn. So NumPy is for the general purpose to pre-process the packages. It provides the high performance multidimensional objects. So it is mainly for the numerical analysis library. So Pandas, Matplotlib, Seaborn, Scikit-learn, these are all the basic libraries for importing in this project. So first I am importing the required libraries, NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, Seaborn, and the second step is the load our data set. So what is our data set? The data set name is the diabetes. So pd.read_csv, diabetes.csv. So when you, so still the cell 1 is executing. So after a completion of the cell 1 only, we have to execute cell 2. Yeah, cell 1 is executed. Now I am executing cell 2. So cell 2 was executed successfully. Now step 3 is the exploratory data analysis. So exploratory data analysis means this is the EDA, also known as the data exploration. It is a step of data analysis process where the number of techniques are used to better understanding of the data set. So in this step, you have to perform the some of the operations like understanding of your data, understanding of your variables. Means variables means about your data set. So data cleaning, like that. So under the understanding of the variables means what kind of operations we have to apply. Head part of the data set, shape of the data set. So list of the all types of the variables and the information of the data set and statistical summary of the data set. So these are the basic understanding of your data set. Let's see. The first step is the head of the data set. So the head function will give you the top records in the data sets. By default, Python will show you the top 5 records. So in place of n, you can take any number. So it will execute from, it will give the result from that many observations. In place of n, if you give the 10, so top 10 records will be displayed. So here I'm displaying the first 5 records. So this is the first 5 records. So in place of here, I mentioned the 10. So it will display the starting 10 records like that. So tail means the last 5 records will be displayed. So our data set from 0 to 768 instances, which means total 768 observations. And display the randomly. If you want to display your data set randomly, you have to give the df.sample of 10 or 5. You can give any number here. That is not an issue. So here, if you see, 523 is the index number, 410, 683, 301, these are randomly taken. But if it is tail means the continuous numbers, last 5 records, 63, 64, 765, 766. Here, top 10 means 0, 1, 2, 3. Head means it, top 10. If you mention the 10 means 10 records will be displayed. If you are not able to mention anything, by default, it will display the top 5 records. So like this. So next part, the shape of the data set. The shape function gives the number of rows and columns. So I want to see how many records are there. So this is my output. So 768, 9, which means 768 rows and 9 columns. So I want to see the list types of the all columns. So by using the df.dtypes, the function will give you the list of the types of the all columns in our data set. Let's see, if I executed this command df.dtypes. So here this is the pregnancy, which type, this is the integer data type. Glucose is also integer, and BMI, and these two features are the float data type. So here one more function, this is info of the data set. This is used to check the information about the data, so the data types with respect to the attributes. So if you using this command df.info, so in this command it will give the result. So how many records are there? 768 instances, which means from 0 to 768. So here 768 non-null values, all here non-null values, which means there is no missing values in the data set. So next to summary of the data set. So the this is the method described will help to see how the data has been spread for the numerical values. So what are the statistical information? The statistical information is the count, mean value, standard deviation, minimum number, 25th percentile, 50th percentile, 75th percentile, and the maximum number. So under the pregnancy, so all input features are the 768 instances, which means that there is no missing value. But this pregnancy, which some of the attributes, the minimum values are 0. So what are the minimum values are 0? Pregnancy, glucose, blood pressure, skin thickness, insulin, BMI. But from this table, what you observed, the minimum value columns, so these are the minimum value columns, has the 0. So it is clear that this value can't be 0. So this value can't be 0, because if you have the knowledge in the data set, you can able to get some kind of knowledge like this attribute should not be minimum, glucose should not be minimum, so blood pressure should not be minimum. So this is the basic minimum knowledge we need based on the data sets. So that's why this is the features we have to replace these values with some other techniques. So here data cleaning. So what is mean by data cleaning? Some data sets may contain duplicates, means the repetitions of the rows may contain. So before going to drop these duplicates, first you have to check what is the shape of the data frame, means 768 rows comma 9 columns. So after applying the method drop duplicates, and again you have to check the shape, which means this is the only way before executing the drop duplicates, you have to check the shape of the frame. After executing the drop duplicates, you have to again to check the shape, which means that both are getting the same shape, means 768 rows, which means that there is no duplicates. If any duplicates is there, so the automatically the after executing the drop duplicates, if you execute the shape, automatically the result will be the duplicates will not be duplicates rows will be deleted, and the remaining rows will be displayed here. So check the null values. So by using this isNull sum function, you can able to see the number of missing values. If you see pregnancy 0, so all values are 0, 0, which means that there is no missing values. So here I'm checking the df.columns, means here display the list of the all columns. So here what I'm doing, actually some of the input variables like glucose, blood pressure, skin thickness, insulin, BMI, these are the have the minimum values, but we don't know how many minimum values are there in glucose. So I'm using this glucose, df of glucose is equal to 0. So if you execute this statement, so which means there are total number of the 0 values in glucose is 5. Similarly, if you execute the blood pressure 35, skin thickness 227, number of 0 values are there, insulin 374 and BMI 11. So which means in this BMI column, so number of zeros are 11. So what I'm doing here, replacing the number of 0 values with this mean of this column. So here I'm replacing the 0 with mean value. So instead of mean, you can also replace with this median also, you can able to check. But here I'm checking the mean value. See, now I have to replace the 0 with this mean of the column. So what is that mean here? Actually, this is the data set. So this is the pregnancy column, this is the glucose column, something like that. So here some values are zeros are there. What I'm doing? So I'm taking, this is the from 0 to 767. It means total is 768 rows comma 9 columns. So in this glucose column, suppose there are the 5 zeros are there. So what I'm doing, I'm taking the mean of the glucose. So mean of the glucose means you have to calculate the mean value of this glucose feature, you will get some value. So you have to replace this wherever 0 is there, you have to replace this with mean value. So that is the meaning of this one. So how can you able to see whether it is executed, whether the 0 replaced or not? So by executing this describe method, so you can able to see here minimum value is 44, 24, 7, insulin 14, 18. Before it is 0, 0 here, the minimum values are 0. Now it is replaced with this mean of the value. Now data visualization. So on the data visualization, first I'm counting the count plot. Count plot means in the target variable, if first let me execute this one. See, so in this diagram, what you observe here? Actually, our data set shape is 768 rows, comma 9 columns. So if 9th column is the outcome, this is the target variable. This is the target variable. The target variable has 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So among the 010101, so I want to see how many unique labels exist in target variable. So I want to find this 0 and 1. Number of zeros are 500. So in this target variable, zeros are nothing but the 500 and 1 is nothing but the 268. So see here, 500, number of zeros are 500 and number of ones are the between, it is about between the 200 and 300, which means this value is about to 268. If you see in the form of percentage, so number of zeros is 500, which means it is 65.65%, and this is about the 35%. So from this diagram, you can able to identify your data set is balanced or not. What does that mean, balance? If you see from this diagram, what you observe, out of 768 samples, 268 samples are positive. So which means this is the positive and this is the negative. So in the outcome, one represent the diabetes positive, zero represent the diabetes negative, which means the diabetes persons are the 268 persons are there, diabetes, and one represent the, out of 268 diabetes predictions, one positive. So this is the positive people are 268 people and negative people are 500 people. So the count plot tells us the data set is imbalanced. So actually in the target variable, it is a binary class. So binary class means 0, 1. So zeros are it about 65% and it is 1 is about 35%, which means I think it is not be not balanced. If it is balanced, means about it is 50 to 50% and 55 to 45, so like that. So but here so much of variation is there, so that's why we used to call the imbalanced data set. So this is imbalanced. By using this diagram, you can able to notice that it is imbalanced data set. So if it is imbalanced data set, what can you supposed to do? By applying this some kind of techniques like undersampling, some one more technique is also there. So by using these techniques, you have to make the data is balanced. So this kind of approach I will explain in the next coming lectures. But this is the project is about only basics. This is the first time I'm giving the classification project in my lectures. So next to histogram. Histogram is one of the most common graphics used to display the numeric data. So here through histograms, so what you observe, so how your data will be distributed. So distributed means either normally distributed or skewness. Skewness means either left skewness or right skewness, like that. So when I'm executing, so this is the age is a feature, BMI is one more feature, blood pressure. So blood pressure is the form, this data will be distributed in the form of the normal distribution. This is the right skewed, left skewed. So from this diagram, you can able to identify your data, how it will be distributed. So the next one is the scatter plot. So by using the scatter plot matrix, this is one type of the graph. In this graph, you can able to identify between the two variables, like age and height. Suppose actually this is not age and height is not our features, but as for example, I'm telling that how this scatter plot is working or useful. So for correlation matrices, it allows you show quickly understanding the, so quickly understanding, so this is the main part, quickly understanding the relationship between the two variables. See, in this diagonal elements are the, so this is the scatter plot matrix. So on the left side, these are the list of the columns. So this is the list of the columns, so pregnancy, glucose, blood pressure, skin thickness. So under the bottom, say blood pressure, skin, glucose, skin thickness. It is like a confusion matrix, not confusion matrix. This is kind of some kind of the correlation matrix kind of approach. So next I am selling the pair plot. So SNS.pair plot, it is a great way to create these scatter plots between all of our variables. So this kind of pair plot is also be working like the scatter plot matrix. So in the scatter plot matrix, the diagonal elements, diagonal diagrams, like this diagram. So these diagrams will be displayed in the form of the histograms. But in pair plot, not like that. So the diagonal pairs will form in another another structure. Let's see how the pair plot will get in. And this pair plot, it will take time compared to rest of the histograms and scatter plot. Yeah, so this is the pair plot. See how the data will be distributed here. So the data will be distributed in the form of the plots, like. Now, analyzing the relationship between the variables, that is a correlation analysis. So correlation analysis is used to quantify the degree to which two variables are raised. So in this correlation matrix, if you able to understand here, if you able to read, can able to understand, you evaluate the correlation coefficient that tells you how much the one variable changes when other one is changing. So when correlation analysis provides you the linear relationship between the two variables. So we correlate the feature variables with the target variable. So we get to know that how much the dependency is there between the particular feature variables and the target variable. So which means, how can you able to identify how the input features are be correlated with this target variable? With this help of this correlation matrix, so you can able to identify. See, in this correlation matrix, the glucose has the more value. Glucose, pregnancies, BMI, age features. So this is the kind of features are be morely correlated with this target variable outcome. So the correlation matrix can also be used as a one of the feature selection technique, which features are the more significant on the target variable, which are most useful, most relevant to the target variable. So after that, now the fifth step is the, now you have to divide your data into X and Y. So X and Y means, now your data set is 768, 9 rows. So 9 rows, so you are dividing the X and Y. So X and Y means X and Y. So in this X means we can take the X1, X2 up to X8, and there is only Y. So you can able to see how the data will be distributed here. If you execute the X dot head means, see here only input, 8 input features are there: pregnancy, glucose, blood pressure, skin thickness, age. But there is no target variable here. So target variable I was separated, and this is one target variable. So now here I'm applying the feature scaling techniques. So what is the feature scaling techniques? So in here there are the 4 different feature scaling techniques available. You can able to check. So in this my project, I am applying the standard scaler. If you want to execute, you have to apply the other scaling techniques like normalizer, minimax scaler, binarizer. So and you can apply this, you can apply the standard scaler, normalizer, minimax scaler and binarizer. So if you execute standard scaler, you will get some kind of accuracy. So if you execute normalizer, you will get another kind of accuracy. So similarly, another accuracy. So 4 different types of accuracy are coming, depends upon the different scaling techniques. So among these accuracies, which one is better, you can able to choose that kind of scaling techniques. But no one can tell you which scaling technique is better. So by practically, you have to execute by yourself on the same data set. Multiple times you have to execute standard scaler, normalizer, minimax scaler, and binarizer. You have to finally compare the accuracies. So here what I'm doing, so for standard scaling, scaling technique have to apply only input feature. That's why I'm giving the I'm passing this x value. So what I'm getting, that's x value I'm passing here. So what this is the for scaling techniques, I have to give to the only input variables. So now after applying the scaling trick, I have to update the SSX. This is my new X, which is the standard scalar. Means after applying this standard scalar, now your data will be different. If you want to know more details about the scaling techniques, recently in one of my playlist I was given one video, that is the different scaling techniques. You can go and watch that video, and again also I will give this the scaling techniques link in this description. Now I have to execute the standard scalar technique. After apply the standard scalar techniques, the seventh step is the train test split. So I am dividing the here I am passing the and this is the standard scalar data and this is the target variable. So I am dividing my data into 80% for the training, 20% for the testing. So my train score is the 614 614, and my test shape will be 154. So while you executing next time, you can change the 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, and you can check the results. Now eighth step is build the classification algorithms. So here I am taking the total 6 different classification algorithms. Those are the logistic regression, KNN algorithm, Naive Bayes algorithm, support vector machine, decision tree, and random forest. So in this project I am taking the 6 different classification algorithms, apply the this training data set. How the result are we are getting? So I am here taking the logistic regression. I'm fit this logistic regression to this X train Y train. Next I'm KNN algorithm, Naive Bayes algorithm, and decision tree, random forest. Now I was applied the 6 different classification algorithms. So now I am making the predictions. So for making the predictions on the test data by using the logistic regression, what I'm doing, so this is LR is my model, logistic regression model, predict on the X test, you will get the Y predict. So before going to execute it here, so I will see what is the X test shape. (154, 8). So after executing this thing, then I will show you again LR dot predict shape. So 154, which means that so your 768 of 9, this is the data, you were divided into 80% for training and 20% for testing. So training data is about to training shape is 614 614, this is this 614 out of 8 rows, this is X train, and 614 this is the Y train, and 154, 8 this is the X test, and 154 is the our Y test. So which means I am dividing the this entire 768, 9, this is 80% for the training, 20% for the testing, this is the X, this is the Y. So which means this is the X train, this is Y train, this is x test and this is the y test. So this x train shape is this 614, 8. This is the 614 and this is 154, 8. This is 154. So here by using this data, this part, we have to train our 6 classification algorithms. So for making predictions, I am supposed to supply this x test and we will get the predicted, that is the y pred. So the y pred is the shape is the this one, this is y test, x test shape 154, 8. The y pred shape is 154. So 154. So which means, if you notice here, we have to apply the evaluation matrix on this part. Y test shape is 154 and y pred also be 154. So we have to apply the evaluation matrix like accuracy, precision, recall. So we will see in upcoming. So making the predictions on the x test by using the KNN algorithm 9.3, that is the naive Bayes prediction. So naive Bayes prediction, I'm giving the name nb.pred. For KNN prediction, I'm using the np.pred. See, for every shape it also be same kn.predict. I will see the shape of this prediction. See, 154. So for a logistic regression prediction is also be 154. For KNN prediction also be same 154. So similarly, I have to apply the prediction by using the support vector classifier, decision tree classifier, and random forest classifier. Now evaluation model, 10th step. So here I am checking the train score and the test score. So what is the train score? Train score means so here and the 80% of the data we have to train our model. So we have to test by using the lr.score. So by importing this library accuracy score for lr is the our model, logistic regression model, dot score x train y train. So x train y train means this is the 614, 8, 614. And for testing, this is the x test. So x test shape is the 154, 8. X train means 614, 8. Y train is the 614. So while you have to apply this our model on this data set, you will get the train score. If you apply the accuracy test on the y test is shape is the 154 and the prediction also be 154. So you will get the accuracy score. So if you apply the accuracy score y test y pred, so if you apply the model dot predict, model name is the lr dot score, you have to apply the x test and y test. So you have to pass this like this. See, when you are applying the model dot score, you have to pass the x test and y test, you will get the test score or the accuracy score. So if you want to apply the import the accuracy score, you have to pass the y test and model lr dot predict. So but you will get the same answer. I will execute here. See, train score, train accuracy score of the logistic regression 77.31. So accuracy score of the logistic regression 77.27, 77, both are same. So here the result is both are same, but the execution style is different. So you are applying the y test y pred. So you are applying the x test y pred, but both are the same. Similarly, I am applying the KNN algorithm, train score, test score, and the naive Bayes, train score, test score. So if you see 100% on the train score of the random forest, test score is the 81%. So we have to consider the based on the test score. Test score means accuracy score. Test score means accuracy score. So based on the accuracy score, we can say our model is good. So here we get in 81%. We can say that our model is good. But here decision tree are getting 79, and here SVM getting 83. This is better than this one. So SVM getting the 83% better than 81% of the random forest. So we have to consider this model, support vector machine. So compared to all models, we have to finalize the which model is better. So confusion matrix. So what do you mean by confusion matrix? The confusion matrix is a table which is used to describe the performance of the classification models. So it visualizes the accuracy of the classifier. So comparing the predicted values with the actual values. The confusion matrix contains the four basic terminologies: so true positive, true negative, false positive, false negative. So if you want to more details about the classification matrix, please watch my videos. You will get full details in this lecture. I will show you. If you want to know full details about the confusion matrix, please watch this video, lecture number 17. So in the lecture number 17, I was clearly explained about the confusion matrix clearly. So I will give this link in description also. So but that's why I'm not going to explain in detail in this lecture. So confusion matrix, I'm applying the importing the from sklearn.matrix classification report and confusion matrix. These are the two libraries are importing from this sklearn.matrix. So confusion matrix, I have to apply y test and y predict. Y predict means here model are predicted. So this is the confusion matrix 86, 11, 24, 33. So when you if you get in the confusion matrix like this, so you don't know which is the true positive, which is true negative, false negative. That's why I'm taking the heat map, SNS.heatmap, confusion matrix. I have to give the same, what are the parameter matrix I'm passing here? Y test LR.predict. So Y test LR.predict also be passing the same here. So if you notice here, the same result also be there, but here graphically, this was somewhat better. So here 86. This is 86, this is 11, this is 11, 24, 24, 33, 33. So here 0, 1, 0, comma. So this is the binary class, that's why 0, 1, 0, 1. If you want to, so in this graph, if you want to give manually, what is the true negative here? Confusion matrix of 0, 0. So 0, 0, you can consider as a true negative. So this is the true negative. 0, 1. So 0, 1. So that is the false positive. This is the false positive. And 1, 0. 1, 0. This is the false negative. And 1, 1. So 1 and 1. This is the true positive. So while apply this one, it executed. So if you want to know what is the true negative, so you can see here true negative is 86, true negative is 86, FP is 11. So FP is 11, this is the 6 true negative. FN 24, this is the FN 24. TP 33. If you want to know more details clearly, the same thing, but here you are getting the accuracy score. So accuracy score 77.27, misclassification rate is the two. Misclassification rate means error rate. If you combine these two things, accuracy score and misclassification rate, so you will get the answer 100. So if you execute this thing, the same thing, confusion matrix of the logistic regression, you are getting the output value with like this, the confusion matrix of the logistic regression. So here I am taking the actual values. So here I am taking the predicted values. This is the predicted values, the 2 negative 86, FE 11, FN 24, TP 33. If I execute this by using this pandas pd dot cross tab, apply the y test and error dot predict, see here the same result we are getting. I am showing the different variations, 86 11, so 86 11, 24 24 33 33. So here this is the 01 and this is the 01. So if you give the false, we'll get the answer like this. If in place of false, if you give the true, so you will get the see what you will get the answer. So which means that, so here false means only confusion matrix. When it is true, including result. So if you add the 86 plus 11, this is the 97. So number of zeros are 97. So number of ones are 24 plus 33, 57. If we add this thing, 154, which means that this y test shape is 154 and y pred also shape 154. That's why this is the value total 154. So here I'm giving the names in place of the outcome on call 0. I'm giving the actual values on the on this left side. So I'm giving the actual names on this side and predicted values on this this side. So that is the difference. And what is the precision? So precision is also known as the PPV, positive predicted value. So this kind of definitions I was clearly explained in my previous lectures. So here I am going to show you the execution. If you take TPFE value, if you executed, this is the precision value, you got 0.75. If you mathematically can have substitute, you will also get the same thing. Precision score 75. So if you notice here, precision score, once execute classification report, you can easily understand. See, so I am taking the precision score library from the sklearn.net matrix. So when you import the precision score library, apply the y test y pred. So this is the value you got, precision 75. So this is the value you got, 75. So when you apply the micro, macro, weighted, weighted and non-weighted, so this kind of technique, evaluation matrix, you have to apply when the data set is the multi-class classification problems. But for binary class, no need. For understanding purpose, I'm explaining here. For if you want to take binary classification project, no need to consider this micro, macro. But if it is better to know everything, that's why I'm giving the macro, macro, weighted, and NaN. So about, if you want to know full details about this kind of topics, what is the micro, macro, weighted, how can you get these values? So this is the macro, this is weighted. For comparison, I will show you the how these values are coming with mathematically. I was explaining in my one of my previous lectures. You can go and watch that one. So here, the precision score is 75. So here precision is 75. So micro. So micro means 75. So micro and average accuracy all are same. That's why this is the value, this value is same. And macro. Macro means 76.59. Macro 76.59. This is the same. But this thing is, it is in the form of percentage. It is the form of the point values. And weighted is 77.00. So weighted is 77.00. So this is the values for comparison purpose I am showing here. But no need to consider the macro, micro, weighted, all those things. If you apply the none in place of the weighted, we will getting two values here. So 78.18 this value. when you apply this, the average is equal to none. We are getting the two values. This is the value, and this is one more value. So this 78.18 is this value, and the 75 is this value. So I clearly explained in my previous lecture about the classification report of this algorithms, how these values are we are getting manually, and also the by coding also. Here also apply the recall. What is the recall? Recall means TP by TP plus FN. So if you see this recall, recall score is 57.89 and 77.27. So micro means this one, and macro means 73.27, and the weighted 77.27. And if you consider this one, average is equal to none. So this is the output values, 88.65. So this is the value you can consider. So 57.89 means this value. And a false positive rate. And a specificity. And F1 score. F1 score means so you can apply the present recall. See F1 score here, I'm applying the I'm taking the F1 score. Here values are same. F1 score value micro 77.27. So macro is 74.21, this value, and the weighted is 76.52, and 83.09 this value, 83.09, 65.34 this values. So all values you are getting in the classification report. ROC curve and AUC. So ROC curve is one of the important evaluation metrics that should be used to check the performance of the classification model, which is ROC curve is also known as the receiver operator characteristics curve. This ROC curve tells about how good our model and can distinguish between the two things, if the patient has a disease or not. So what is mean by area under curve, AUC? So this helps to choose the best model, to help to choose the best model among the different models and which have the plotted the ROC curve. ROC curve and executing the ROC curve. So ROC curve, ROC AUC underscore score. This is the library. I am applying the Y test and LR underscore predict. So this all functions, evaluation metrics, we have to apply on this kind of Y test and LR pred. So confusion matrix, classification report, precision, recall, and everything we have to apply Y test and Y pred. So this is the AU ROC score. If you apply the, so this is the ROC curve. So this is the receiver operating curve. So this is the value about 0.73. So this is the about the this is the result about the logistic regression. In the similar way, you have to this is about the K-NN algorithm. The same structure you have to apply. So here also be getting the values. You can follow the same structure, but I'm not going to explain here. But I'm showing the how the project will be looks like when you apply the different classification algorithms. How can you able to compare? So for this demonstration purpose, I'm showing the all kind of algorithms for comparison and which one is the better one. So this is the confusion matrix of the random forest. This is the random forest confusion matrix and classification report. So this is the ROC of the ROC curve of the random forest. This is the confusion matrix of the random forest. This is the ROC curve of the Decision tree and the classification report of the Decision tree, confusion matrix of the Decision tree, and ROC curve of the support vector machine, classification report of the support vector machine, confusion matrix of the support vector machine, ROC curve of the Naive Bayes, classification report of the Naive Bayes, confusion matrix of the Naive Bayes, and KNN algorithms, ROC curve, classification report of KNN, confusion matrix of the KNN, and the ROC curve of the logistic regression, classification report of the logistic regression, and confusion matrix of this logistic regression. So this is the way we can able to compare the different classification algorithms based on the evaluation, based on the accuracies, we can able to choose the best model. So this is the end-to-end project for binary classification project. In place of the, if you want to do multi-class, you can also this same structure. At that time, you have to consider the macro, micro, weighted average, precision matrix, evaluation matrix. And in the same project, actually in this project, I am not applying the cross-validation techniques. I am not applying the feature selection techniques. I am not applying the hyperparameter tuning. So this kind of techniques, actually in this project, I am not applying. Not apply the first one, feature scaling, feature selection techniques, which features are important. And I didn't apply the, this is the feature selection, I didn't apply the cross validation techniques, and I didn't apply the hyperparameter tuning, and I didn't check the outliers. So this kind of steps you have to do, apply in your project, then only you can say. So this is the basic project without applying feature selection, without applying cross validation, without applying hyperparameter tuning, without applying the identifying the outliers and removing. So this is the project of the basic project. I am applying the basic algorithms and check the results and compare the results. So in the next project, next lecture, I will also using the same data set, and I will compare this feature selections, cross validations, hyperparameter tuning, and outliers. So this is the concept, friends. This is the concept. Okay. If you have any kind of doubts and any kind of comments, please post it in comment box. And I will also give the other videos lectures links. Thank you.